Such a hurry.
The paved track. I want to see all the work they've done setting up for the qualifiers for the Great Truck Games.
Did you forget you were going to help me put away the supplies in the diner?
I didn't forget. I was just hoping you'd let me see the cool stunt gear first.
Tell you what, champ. If you don't take too long, why don't you go have a look, then help me afterward.
Red Hot Turbochargers! Thanks!
Your gears don't sound so good. Have you done your maintenance yet?
Do I have to? It's so boring.
Chuck, you gotta keep your gears and circuits in good shape so you can be fast and strong.
Come on, Porter. While Chuck does that, we can get a head start on cleaning up the diner.
Guess I better get this over with. This is going to take forever. I wish there was a faster way. Only a few laps left. Better make a quick pit stop. Guys, I need some maintenance, but I don't have much time. Gotta get back on the track if I want to win.
We'll have you across that finish line in no time.
Thanks, guys. You're the fastest pit crew in the whole world.
Go get him, partner. Yay, Team Chuck!
Take forever. Besides, my gear shift okay? Well, maybe they could use some maintenance, but will one more day really matter?
Hey, Chuck. The half pipe's finished if you want to try it out.
Awesome!
Whoa, buddy. Sounds like you could use a little maintenance.
Right. Maintenance.
Sure. Nothing keeps a truck feeling better. In fact, I'm off to have a little work done myself before I haul this crane away.
Come on, Chuck. This is so fun!
Well, have a good time, Chuck. But don't push those gears too hard.
I won't.
Hey, Chuck, something wrong with your engine?
I think my gears are just a little stiff. It's nothing.
Reckon you ought to be on the half pipe? Your insides sound louder than a gas tank full of lug nuts.
I'll be fine. Watch this. I did it. Now I just need to turn around. Whoa! Ah!
Better work on your landing, Chuck.
Why are you going backwards?
No reason. I can go forwards, no problem. Watch! Watch! Watch!
Why don't you just stay there and let me have a look?
What's wrong with him, Handy?
He's so low on transmission fluid that his gears won't shift.
You mean I'm stuck in reverse?
Chuck? Chuck? There you are, champ. I could really use your help at the diner.
Thank goodness you're here, Mr. Chuck's dad. You've got to help us.
No, Handy. I'm going to help him to clean up the diner.
Huh?
I'll be right there, Dad.
Okay. See you in a minute.
I don't get it, Chuck. Why didn't you tell him?
Because I was supposed to do my maintenance this morning, but I was so excited to get to the racetrack that I skipped it. And now if Dad finds out I'm stuck in reverse, I'll be in big trouble.
You're not going to tell him?
I'll just help him now, and we'll figure out how to fix me later. He won't even have to find out.
We'll pump my tires and call me flat. It sure is busy.
Is there anything better than a nice round of maintenance, boys?
Yeah. I think I can do this, but will you guys stick around to make sure nothing goes wrong?
Sure we will, Chuck.
Uh-oh.
Here comes your dad.
If he sees you guys here, he might realize something's wrong. You better hide.
Good, you're here. Can you move those bumpers out of the way?
No problem.
He's got him!
This is actually sort of fun. Sorry.
Oh, no. Chuck's in trouble.
Look, Andy. My first job for Dad is finished. And I did the whole thing in reverse.
Yeah, you sure did.
That was close, Chuck.
Yeah,
you may not be so lucky next time. Maybe you ought to tell your dad about your gear problem.
Come on, guys. It worked out fine. With your help, I can do everything Dad wants. Bumpers up.
Bumpers up.
Sure couldn't have done it without you guys.
We're just glad it's over, Chuck.
Yeah, and if you ever get stuck in reverse again, you're telling your dad right away instead of dragging us into it.
Deal. Now, come on. Let's get back to the half pipe.
Now you're talking.
Hold on a second, Chuck. There's just one more thing. Can you put these new bumpers back on the shelf for me? I've got to go to the repair center to help your mother.
Oh, sure thing, Dad. No, my friends are already gone. Guess I'm on my own this time. Well, so far so good. Slow and steady, and I'll be just fine. What's going on?
Well, it's time this old crane and I hit the road.
Look out! Like Mom and Dad asked. Come on, maybe I can still make things right. And then the crane started moving around on its own. I'm so sorry, it's all my fault.
We'll talk about that later, but right now, we need to stop that crane. And we need your help, Chuck. We need everybody's help.
Sure.
You got it.
Anything. I better go evacuate the diner so nobody gets hurt.
I'm gonna try to get past that claw so I can shut the crane off.
Maybe we can help stop the claw so Dad can get to the controls easier. I wonder if we can use our half-pipe jumps to solve the problem. Okay, Biggs and I used the crates to block the crane. Now all we have to do is stop the claw so Dad can reach the controls.
Use easier ropes to lasso the claw.
All right, everyone, let's stop that claw. We got it. Hold on tight, Biggs.
Chuck, you can ease up now.
Chuck, you can let go now.
I knew that.
Nice work, everyone.
Mom, Dad, I'm really sorry. If I had listened to you in the first place, none of this would have happened. And then I was so worried about you being mad at me that I made things worse by hiding my stuck gears.
We're proud you told us the truth, Chuck, even if it took a little longer than it should have.
And I'm sorry I put you guys through all that stuff, too.
Well, you still need to make up for your mistake. You can start by cleaning up the mess you caused in the diner.
No problem. I'll do it right away. After I do my maintenance.
Give me a mountain to climb and watch me do it. Yeah. Any day, any time, you know I'm up to it. I got what it takes to come through, 'cause there's nothing I can't do. Gonna make all my dreams come true, 'cause there's nothing I can't do.
Than any model truck ever made.
Our truck's going to zoom so fast over this ramp, it will fly over Boomer, and who knows how far.
Well, everybody, Chuck claims he's built the world's fastest toy truck. Today, we'll see if it's true. Wait now, what's this, folks? A jetpack. Oh, hold on to your fenders, folks. Here we go! Unbelievable! Ladies and gentle trucks, you are looking at the world's fastest toy truck!
Wow! I can't wait to see how far it goes. Ready and go!
Did you say it was gonna go over me or in front of me?
I wonder why it didn't go faster.
Cute ride, dude.
Cute? Our truck's not cute. It's a super awesome racing machine.
Hi, I'm Chuck. Who are you?
Spinner's the name, you know, 'cause I spin. My mom's getting a tune-up, so I just need a place to hang out. I see you put up a ramp for jumping your model truck. Want to see a real model truck take that jump? See?
Whoa! That was fast!
Guess an engine really helps.
You just can't get that kind of speed from your homemade truck.
Yeah? But we're not done building ours. Once we are, it'll race faster and jump farther even without an engine.
How about a jump-off? And whichever truck jumps farther wins. And gets to keep that awesome hood ornament.
I'm not sure that
we'll do it. Meet us back here at 4 o'clock.
You got it. See you at 4.
Why did you do that? That truck didn't seem very nice, and we might end up giving him our cool hood ornament.
Hold on, Boomer. If Flip says we can do it, then he must have a plan. Right, Flip?
I was kind of hoping one of you guys would have a plan.
Our truck can't beat a truck with an engine. It's impossible.
Well, we couldn't just let that show-off win. What do you think, Chuck? Is it really impossible?
Nothing's impossible. First, we need to figure out the reasons why our truck is going slow. Once we know those, we can think of ways to make it go faster. And I know an expert on speed who can help us for sure. Rally's home in between races. Don't blink or you'll miss him.
Either something's wrong with my blinkers or Rally's going slow.
My speed reader agrees with you. It shows me how fast Rally's going. When his wheels bounce off the ground, they aren't pushing him forward as much, so he goes slower.
The ground was bumpy at the parts yard, too.
And our model truck was also bouncing around a lot.
Mom, we're trying to make our model truck go faster, and it might be having the same problem as Rally. What are you going to do to help Rally go faster?
Well, what Rally really needs are new shock absorbers. That's the part that keeps your wheels from bouncing too much on a bumpy road.
I know! Let's give our truck shock absorbers!
Unfortunately, we don't make them that small.
Power and pickups! We may not be able to give our truck shock absorbers, but we can get rid of the bumps another way by smoothing out the ground.
That could work.
Great idea!
Not a bad start. Here, take my speed reader. It'll help you clock your truck's speed. I'm off to install Rally's new shock absorbers.
Thanks, Mom. The ground's nice and smooth now. Let's see if our truck goes faster. Red Hot Turbochargers! It is faster!
It's speedy, all right. Maybe we can win this thing. Or maybe we're gonna lose our hood ornament.
We can't give up yet.
Think.
Ah! I can't think with all that squeaking.
Maybe if I...
Nope. This side doesn't like the squeaking either.
That squeak may be telling us something. Let's see if Rally knows what it's saying. Hey, Rally. Can you tell us what the squeaking sound is?
Sure. That squeaking means there's friction.
What's friction?
Friction is when two things rub against each other. It sounds like the truck's axle, the part the wheels are attached to, is rubbing against something. Luckily, you can get rid of friction by putting something slippery between the things rubbing together. Let me show you. Try and bring me that heavy fender. Not so easy, right? But if you had something slippery under the fender...
I know something slippery.
We got rid of a lot of the friction.
And you made a mess.
Sorry, Mom. We were just figuring out how to make our toy truck go faster. We need to put mud on the axles to make it slippery in there.
I have a better idea. Use this oil to grease the truck's axle instead.
Thanks, Mom. I guess oil is what you usually use for trucks.
Now let's see if our model truck has more vroom than squeak. The truck's going faster without the friction.
Uh-oh. When the truck pushed against the spring in the shock absorber, the spring stored up some energy inside. It used that energy to push your truck.
Better go get it. Thanks, Mom. Thanks, Rally.
We'll catch it now. I always go faster down hills.
The problem is the toy truck's going faster, too.
It is going faster. That gives me an idea. Come on! Since things fall faster when they're up high, like on a hill, maybe this downhill ramp will make our truck go faster. It's getting great speed just from going downhill.
And with no bumps on the track, it's going even faster.
Without friction on the axles, it should sail right over Boomer.
I'm pretty sure it didn't.
Why isn't it fast enough? We've tried everything.
Maybe it's just not possible to beat a truck bought in a store.
Sorry I got us into this, guys.
Hey, guys, look how fast I can race with my new shock absorbers. Look how bouncy they are.
Power and pickups! Rally, what did Mom do with your old shocks?
Well, I guess she was going to throw them out.
Where'd he go? Guess your dump truck friend realized a homemade truck just can't be at a store-bought one.
Spinner? But it's not 4 o'clock yet. He'll be back.
Okay, but if he's not, I win that hood ornament. 4 o'clock. Looks like that hood ornament is mine.
Not yet, Spinner. Guys, remember how the Spring and Rally shock absorber made our truck zoom out of the repair center?
Rally said the spring stored up energy when it was pushed in.
Then use that energy to push our truck out the door.
Exactly. Maybe it can do the same on our truck.
We'll see about that.
It's not over yet, guys. Maybe, just maybe, this will give our truck enough of a push to get over Boomer.
Ready, set, go!
Whoa!
Awesome!
Yes! But we won!
It was easy, once you know a few things about speed.
I'm really sorry I made fun of your homemade truck. I guess I was showing off before.
Hey, Spinner, wait. I bet we could help you make your truck go faster, too.
You would do that?
Of course.
Sure.
No problem.
Then we can have another jump off. This time, whoever wins gets...
Flip.
What? I was just going to say whoever wins gets a nice round of applause.
Of the Junior Sparkplug Rangers Troop 9 is called to order. Ranger Boomer will lead you all in the reciting of the Sparkplug Oath.
Yes, sir. Our Junior Sparkplug stands for...
Resourcefulness, teamwork, honor, and a clean windshield.
Now, I've been teaching you all the fine points of tracking, how to follow a trail, pick up clues, zero in on your target. Well, the time has finally come for you to earn... your badges for tracking!
Oh, yeah!
Wahoo.
All right!
Whoa!
That Desperado Diesel ain't got a chance of escaping with you tracking him, Deputy Chuck.
Looky here, trusty sidekick. This cactus is missing just 3 needles at the exact height of Desperado Diesel's side mirror. Sounds like a herd of stampeding semis are approaching. And it sounds like they're light blue.
You can't tell what color they are just from listening to the ground.
That big one on the end with the cactus scratches on his mirror. That's Desperado Diesel. After them.
You'll never catch me now!
Gotcha! Take him away, trusty sidekick.
As mayor, I hereby present you with this really shiny badge, making you the new sheriff of Breakshoe Bluff.
All right!
Boys, I've taught you the tricks of tracking trucks. But if you ever find yourself in a jam, just remember the words of the good old Ranger Oath. Resourcefulness, teamwork, honor, and a clean windshield.
I can do that, sir.
I can do it better.
Here they go again. Chuck and Flip are always trying to outdo one another.
I bet I'll be polishing my badge while you're still coughing my dust. In your dreams, Flip.
Settle down, Rangers. Remember, this here ain't a contest. Now, here's the rules. Each of you will use your tracking skills to find these here parts which I hid around the truck stop. There's 4 of each part, so you can all earn your badge. Only thing you gotta do is track them down and collect them all in 10 minutes. Okay, first thing's a wheelbarrow tire.
and I'll start you off with a hint. Biggs, yours is 20 truck lengths due south. Boomer, you go 20 truck lengths due west. Flip, 20 north. And Chuck, look for your wheelbarrow tire 20 truck lengths east. You can use your compasses to tell which direction is which. Now, everybody ready?
I'll just take out my trusty compass. Huh? Where's my compass? Uh-oh, I left it at home. Wait, maybe I don't need a compass. Scoutmaster Biggers once said, the sun rises in the east. The sun came up over there, which means that way's east. So 20 truck lengths that way.
Wheelbarrow tire, wheelbarrow tire.
Bingo! 18, 19, 20. That tire track's smaller than the others. Like maybe for a wheelbarrow tire. Hey, Flip, look. I didn't even need a compass. That's because I'm resourceful, just like it says in the Ranger Oath.
You're still on the wheelbarrow tire?
I'm already on the truck radiator.
Okay, looking for a truck radiator. Let's see here. Grease marks, tire tracks, oil drips. Okay, if Chuck can be resourceful, I can be twice as resourceful. Think.
That doesn't look like these other oil drips.
And it doesn't smell like an oil drip. It smells kind of like rusty water, like from a radiator. Oh, yeah!
Racing flag.
Oh, this is part of a racing flag, but where's the stick thingy?
Boomer!
Will flatten my tires and call me Shorty.
Hi, Biggs.
Hey,
you found a flag. Well, that's what I've been looking for. So far, all I found are these here two flag sticks.
That's what I've been looking for.
You know what? If you put your cloth together with one of my sticks, we got ourselves a checkered flag.
But we'd only have one, and we both need a flag.
Well, that's true. Oh, wait a second. Remember what the Ranger O says right after resourcefulness?
Teamwork? Oh, I see. So you can give me one of the sticks you found, and we can team up to find the other cloth.
Let's do it, partner.
Sockets. A whole trail of sockets. And where there's sockets, there's gotta be a socket wrench. Power and pickups. Now I've got half the stuff on the list. Wonder how much Flip's got. Oh no, here he comes. And there's another socket wrench. If Flip finds it, he might finish before me. Maybe I shouldn't. But I don't want to finish second.
Oh no! Chuck already has a socket wrench? I can't let him beat me.
Huh? How did he? Oh no! He got my socket wrench!
Aha!
Windshield wiper. That's all I need, and I'm done. Hey, a windshield! And it's missing its wipers! It's kinda like someone was trying to fix them. That's it, the repair shop! Got it!
Not yet, you don't!
Hey, that's mine!
Let go!
You let go!
Now look what you did!
Me? You mean you?
Time's up! Spark plugs assemble! Yep, that's right. Got it. Good job, Boomer. You got it all. Here's your tracking badge. So far, both y'all have proven your resourcefulness.
We also used something else that spark plug rangers need.
We used teamwork.
I reckon you did, son. I mean, Junior Spark Plug Ranger.
The wiper's mine! I found it!
You mean mine! I got it first!
Whoa, what happened here?
Well, it kinda got busted, and now we've both got half a wiper. So who gets the badge?
Well, I can't answer that. You're gonna have to figure that out on your own. But let's see. When a spark plug isn't sure what to do, the first thing to do is go back and check the spark plug oath, like Boomer and Biggs did. Remember what it says?
A junior spark plug stands for resourcefulness, teamwork.
I guess we sort of forgot about teamwork.
In fact, we were trying to race against each other to finish first.
And we also forgot something else. The last part of the oath.
Huh? But our windshields are spotless.
Flip, the oath says resourcefulness, teamwork, and honor. Honor means doing the right thing, like being honest and fair. Remember?
Oh, right. Like seeing things from the other guy's point of view. You know, I suppose you did see the wiper first,
but you were the first to get it. I might have forgotten about honor when I tried to hide your socket wrench.
And when I swiped yours from you.
I think honor may be the most important part of the oath.
It's kind of what the other parts are all about.
Well, good for you both for figuring that out. Now, the only question is, which one gets to earn his badge?
Neither of us.
We didn't live up to the spark plug oath today, so we definitely didn't earn our badges.
Well, I am impressed with the honest and unselfish judgment you've just shown. You may not have won your tracking badge today, but you each just earned yourself a genuine spark plug honor badge.
Power and pickups! Look how shiny this is!
Give me a mountain to climb and watch me do it, yeah. Any day, any time, you know I'm up to it. I got what it takes to come through, 'cause there's nothing I can't do. Gonna make all my dreams come true, 'cause there's nothing I can't do.
Inside Badly Bumper's lair, the wheel heroes make a daring attempt to escape.
I've got you now, Zoom Zoomerton.
Watch out!
No. Careful, Zoom!
But wait! What's this? Zoom Zoomerton opens a trap door to reveal a fantastic quick escape slide!
Awesome!
You're trapped, wheel hero!
Make a daring escape, just like them. Whoosh, whoosh.
But how? We don't have a big escape slide like that.
Not yet. But I know the perfect place to build a slide. To the clubhouse, guys. We can make the slide start way up here.
Do you think it could go like a corkscrew all the way down?
And then maybe it could lead to a ramp that shoots us onto the trampoline.
Those are both great ideas. Let's do it.
Chuck? How are we gonna build it that high? My ladder only goes up to here.
don't know. Yet. But let's look around the parts yard for stuff we can build with. I'll bet we'll figure something out.
Ooh, I bet we could use this.
I saw it first.
I was just gonna take that.
Not anymore.
Wait, don't break it. We need that.
Are you gonna stop me?
Guinness, who's that?
Hi, I'm Chuck, and this is Digger and Boomer. What's your name?
Billy. My dad brought me to this old truck stop and told me to wait while he got it chewed up. So I'm just here looking for something to break.
Hey, don't! Maybe we should get Chuck's dad.
Oh, are you going to tell? I didn't know you were a bunch of tattle trucks.
It's okay, Boomer. We can figure this out ourselves. Billy, I was just noticing your crate. Is it new?
I just had it installed. Bet you guys don't have anything that can reach this high.
Whoa! No, we don't. But it would be great if we had something like that to finish our project. Do you want to help us?
Help? How?
Come on, we'll show you. So there's gonna be this huge corkscrew. Zoom! And then you'll go right up a ramp and land on the trampoline. It's so awesome you have a crane. That's just what we need to build our slide really high.
My crane? Whoa! For your dumb clubhouse? No way. Besides, I didn't come here to help. I came here to break stuff.
I don't think he's gonna help.
I think we should get a grown-up.
No way, guys. We're not tattle trucks, remember? Maybe he just needs some time to warm up.
That's true. And maybe then he'll help us build the slide.
Woohoo! Yeah! Check this out!
You have to wear safety gear on the half pipe.
I don't have to do anything.
You know, Billy, it might be fun if you helped us. What do you think?
You know what would be even more fun?
What?
Knocking it down!
Billy, you're ruining our slide!
I'm not ruining your dumb slide. I'm just playing a game. It's called Knock It Down.
That's not a game. Is it?
Sure it is. And if you guys weren't such goody two-wheels, you'd like playing it too.
Guys, I really think we should get a grown-up now.
No way! There's three of us and one of him. We don't need help.
Yeah, we built our whole clubhouse by ourselves, solos.
And we can build a slide without a crane if we have to.
But what if Billy comes back?
We can take care of that, too.
He's angry. He's surly.
He makes our bubbles go curly. Watch out for the bully.
He's rough.
He's tough.
He messes with our stuff. Watch out for the bully. Watch out for the bully. Uh-oh, the bully don't care now. If our feelings get bruised. Uh-oh, the bully don't care now. We have to stop him. He's just fabulous.
He's cold.
He's cruel.
He thinks breaking things is cool.
Watch out for the bully. Watch out for the bully. Uh-oh, the bully don't care now. If our feelings get bruised. Uh-oh, the bully don't care now. We ask him to stop, but he's just bad news. Uh-oh, the bully don't care now. If our feelings get bruised. Uh-oh, the bully don't care now. We ask him to stop, but he's just bad news. He's the bully!
Let's see him get through this. Knocking down our slide again.
Oh, yes, I am.
We need to tell him.
No, we can work this out.
Why don't you go tell? Your friend's a scaredy truck.
That's it, Billy. Stop calling us names. You need to leave our slide alone.
Says who?
Says me.
You really told on me?
I know when we need help, so I got a grown-up.
You did the right thing, Boomer.
Billy wasn't playing fair. In fact, he was being mean. Maybe we can still work things out, but we need a grown-up here to help.
Dad, we did everything we were supposed to do. We asked Billy if he wanted to play with us. We tried to talk to him about not knocking down our slide. We even ignored him. But he's just a big bully who wants to ruin stuff.
That does sound unfair, but now that I'm here, why don't you try again?
We all want to play with you. Why are you being so mean? You really could have helped us with that awesome crane.
That's the problem. My new crane.
Your crane? Why?
I don't know how to use it yet. My dad's been trying to teach me, but I'm really having trouble. Then when I saw how great you and your friends were at building stuff, I was mad I couldn't do the things you guys do.
You didn't have to act how you did. We would have understood. I had a training shovel before I got esta pala grande, this big shovel.
And I used to accidentally set my siren off all the time.
We all have to practice a lot to learn new things.
You're right. I'm really sorry I was such a bully. I'll leave you alone now.
Oh, wait!
Help us out anyway. We can always use another set of wheels.
Really?
Yeah!
Vámonos, amigo!
Wow, okay, thanks! Slide was much more fun than knocking it down. And playing with friends is much more fun than playing alone or breaking stuff.
Yeah, it is. And now comes the best part, trying out the slide. Come on, wheel heroes.
Wait, Billy should be the first to try the slide. After all, we couldn't have done it without him.
Yeah.
You go first, amigo.
Go on.
Zoom Zoomer 10 and the wheel heroes have done it again. You'll never get us now, badly, bumpers!
Oh, yeah.